Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Dr Amel from City Skin Clinic, and today I'm going to talk to you about acne. This is an incredibly common but really kind of can be almost devastating skin condition, and I wanted to kind of go through some of the most common things that we speak with our patients about in the clinic. And also just discuss a little bit about what causes acne and kind of the basis for professional treatments and medications for acne. I will be doing some more videos on acne treatments, specifically the treatments that we offer at our clinic. But this is just a really nice overview that I think will provide a good baseline, and it's based on the most common questions that we also get. What's acne? Well, acne is a skin condition. It's often characterized by comedones, which, you know, if you think about, are pimples. And usually it's a cycle of inflammation. You get breakouts, often accompanied by skin being irritated and red. And then acne scarring and hyperpigmentation, post-inflammatory pigmentation, can also happen as kind of late stages of this. Acne is quite a dynamic skin condition, so there are lots of things that affect when people have acne or acne breakouts, but also lots of factors that affect improvement and then restarting. So in order to kind of understand this complexity, it's worth thinking about acne like we do with all skin problems. There are things that are intrinsic to you, and then there are outside factors as well. So a really, really big thing with acne is hormones and the impact they play. So we know things like androgens have a huge effect on acne formation, and we know, for example, that there are certain conditions, medical conditions like polycystic ovarian syndrome, which are associated with acne. Also know that the onset of puberty, that's a big time for people to come out with acne. But also there are other periods, for example, the surge of hormones that happens before the menopause. Again, that's a period where some women may experience acne breakouts. Acne can be something that someone goes through sort of their whole life, or it's more common, it's something that may come and go, and the severity will vary. And that kind of, again, it's important to sort of understand what is happening with your acne in order to be able to adapt treatment to help you overcome. So on that journey, it's also important to understand there are outside factors that can have an impact. So for example, you know, not all makeup, but sometimes makeup or skin products that have a heavy oil content or that are comedogenic, these can also worsen or trigger breakouts. So again, being mindful, which everyone who suffers from acne is almost always, about what you put on your skin and what is likely to trigger a breakout. And then a slightly controversial one, and we're understanding more about it, is diet. So up until about 2005, it wasn't thought that diet played any role in acne, but as we start to see more kind of small trials come through, there may be an association with sugar, and I would imagine it's probably to do with the hyper-inflammatory process that sugar triggers in cells. And if you think of it, it's really important to understand acne as an inflammatory condition as well. So that may be associated with that, and there are some trials that suggest that having a high glycemic index diet may affect acne and acne breakouts, and I'll leave a link to that information below if you're interested. So the stages of acne, it's important to think that there are multi-factors. So one of them is an abnormal epithelialization, the pores, which is where kind of the inflammatory reaction or the acne kind of reaction erupts, and become abnormally epithelialized. To put it simply, clogged up with cells, dead cells, living cells abnormally. So skin cells kind of line this up. And then you end up also with, which is where the hormones come in, sort of androgens cause excessive production of sebum or oil in the oil glands. And then that creates this kind of beautiful niche for bacteria to grow. So p.acnes is the main bacteria that's implicated in acne formation. And so when you have these factors, and then the bacteria, as they grow and they thrive, they cause inflammation. And then what does that mean for you? That ends up giving rise to excess oil production, it gives rise to redness and irritated skin, and very characteristic of acne, you get these breakouts, these pimples. And these, there are different grades of pimples. It can vary from anything from little whiteheads to pustules in more severe cases. And this is what a lot of people think of when they think of acne, but there is a spectrum of this, and where you are on that spectrum is how severe that reaction is happening. So what this means is it's important to kind of realize there is no one single treatment that will cure or improve acne, and it's a combination of things. So in terms of treatments, and one of the things that we generally look to do is to treat firstly the epithelialization. Something that does that really well is tretinoin. So this is a retinoid, and that helps with that kind of abnormal clumping of cells and clogging up of the pores. So for those who can't have tretinoin, retinol may be a less active alternative to that. And in people with incredibly severe acne, that then they may have to go to oral isotretinoins. So this is things like accutane, which again, the idea is to help with the abnormal cellularization. Tretinoin and isotretinoin retinol also help with texture of the skin, so they're really good in also helping treat acne scarring and smoothing the skin as well. And they can also really help with any hyperpigmentation, so that post-inflammatory pigmentation that we talked about in our last video. So these are, you know, treatments that really help different stages. In terms of the bacteria itself, well, we know that actually things like benzoyl peroxide, benzoyl peroxidase, that really helps with treating the bacteria and killing it. So again, BPO is really good if you use it in a face wash, whereas tretinoin or retinol, these are used at the end as a cream or a serum in the case of retinol. And then we have things like azelaic acid and salicylic acid, which again help with exfoliation. They help with regulation of oil, and these are usually best used as a toner in the case, in my opinion, of salicylic acid, or as a cream in azelaic acid or salicylic acid. And again, if you head over to our website, we've got a new A to Z of skincare section, and that discusses these products in more detail. The BPO, salicylic acid, retinol, azelaic acid, these are things that you can get over the counter, and that's really good in very mild cases of acne. If you've been struggling a bit with acne and you're on the mild to moderate end, then you may need to consider actually looking at more professional skincare, so things like tretinoin, and also so in our clinic we also provide for mild to moderate acne the Obagi Clenziderm MD, which is a professional at-home treatment that does also contain salicylic acid and BPO at prescription strengths. And we combine that with tretinoin if you're suitable for tretinoin, and that can really help, and many people will see results in as little as 2 weeks. On that point, I just want to really stress out, particularly with acne, it is a complex condition, and whether you go down the professional skincare route or whether you have in-clinic treatments like chemical peels, We have a range of different chemical peels that can be customized to treat you, or whether you have at home sort of over-the-counter skincare. The important thing is consistency, and it's also adapting it as your skin starts to respond. It's really important not to give up acne, especially if you've gone to the effort to get products and you have high expectations. It can feel a bit soul-crushing if you don't see results fairly quickly, but it's really important to understand that persistence and perseverance is key, and also listening to your skin. And that may sometimes mean adding other ingredients or increasing strength or frequencies or tapering them down. So it is a very active kind of living process, and with that journey, I would say it's almost a lifelong journey with skin. Even if you do combat acne, being aware that you can have breakouts at any point, and sort of starting to think about how you can reduce triggers like stress, or whether if there are any underlying medical conditions like polycystic ovary syndrome or any androgen hormone problems. So again, it's understanding that. So what I would like to say, wrapping up this video, is it's just the take-home messages I've always thought about acne are: it's a complex, multifactorial problem. It is treatable, but it's about kind of understanding what the underlying problem is and treating that. And also with the acne, choosing the best treatment that's going, or treatments that's going to help with your specific skin problem, and prioritizing it. Is your acne at the stage where you're having breakouts only? Are you suffering from kind of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and scarring? Is it a combination of these? Because different things will treat different conditions. And then just having a bit of faith and a little bit of perseverance, and it really does, it's not impossible to kind of treat this, it's just treating it appropriately. Anyway, I left some links below to our website on sort of acne itself and the treatments that we offer, as well as just general information about skincare ingredients that work well for acne and acne scarring and post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. I will do some more videos on acne treatments. If there's anything that you would like me specifically to cover, or you have any questions, please leave a comment below. And don't forget to like this video, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe and hit the notifications button so that you know when our next video is up. Until then, have a great day.